Bonjour à tous et bienvenue pour cette nouvelle édition de votre magazine. À l'approche des fêtes de fin d'année, on a voulu se rapprocher au plus près du Père Noël, d'où cet environnement très enneigé, puisque nous sommes à Helsinki, en Finlande. Et oui, Cita Finlande nous a fait le plaisir de bien vouloir nous accueillir. Forêts, lacs, marais, rivières, la Finlande est avant tout le pays des amoureux de la nature. Si le nord du pays héberge le Père Noël et ses lutins, c'est aussi là que vivent une grande partie des 200 000 rennes présents sur le territoire. La Finlande est également connue pour ses aurores boréales, ses nuits éternelles et le froid extrême des hivers à rallonge. Tout ceci justifie bien les 2 millions de saunas comptabilisés dans le pays. Au sud, là où habite la majorité des 5 400 000 habitants, se situe Helsinki et le siège de Cita Finlande. Depuis 1998, Cita est implantée dans ce pays et vous allez voir que malgré la neige et le froid, la collecte des déchets est assurée avec succès. Tout de suite, je vous propose de retrouver Jorma Kangas, le responsable de Cita en Finlande. Hello, Jorma.
Hello, Fabian. Nice to have you here.
Thank you very much. So tell me everything about Cita Finland.
Cita Finland has been in Finland for about 15 years now. We have 350 employees. They are workers, but we also have about 10 plant sites for waste recovery. From being a traditional waste management company, we are shifting into more and more material recovery and secondary raw materials. It's becoming more and more of our business. We would like to say that we are nationwide, but way up in the north and eastern part of the country, there are so few people, so we are not present there.
And we're going to go to Vaasa pretty soon. What should I expect over there?
At this time of the year, you will expect lots of snow,
again,
cold weather and nice people.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Pour mieux comprendre les activités de Cita Finlande, je vais aller retrouver Marit Lepanen, la directrice du marketing et du développement commercial. Et je vais vite aller enfiler ma doudoune et mon bonnet parce qu'il fait moins 13 dehors quand même. Hello.
Hello, bonjour. Fabien, welcome to Finland.
Thank you, nice to meet you. So it's very cold in Finland.
This is typical Finnish winter right now.
Yeah, it's pretty, but there's lots of snow. So I was wondering, how do you do to manage waste collection here, with so many snow.
To Finnish people, the winter doesn't come as a surprise, which means that planning up front is everything. Which means that we have to plan that how our trucks will start in the morning when it's really cold, and how to be prepared that it all takes a little more time than usually. The collecting the waste, I mean.
And I was wondering, with the low temperature, I bet people get late because of the roads or they get sick. How do you manage that?
We have a very good occupational health care, which prevents that we don't get sick that easily. That's of course the prevention and the planning. Like I said, it's everything. But when people get sick and they all sometimes do, we have a plan for that as well. Which means that sometimes people work overtime, those who are healthy and here. And the other option is subcontractors. We have a very good network of subcontractors in Finland.
What is your main business priority here in Finland?
Our focus is in industrial and commercial side, those segments. But of course we serve the household as well.
I heard about three areas. What is it exactly?
Three areas means that in Finland we have two waste collection systems. The other one is that we can freely make agreements with the private households and offer our services to them. And the other option is the municipal system, which means that we are subcontractors to the municipal companies.
And what about your customer service? I heard it's a key element here.
It's a key element because it helps us to interact with our customers. We know about their needs. We can offer, for instance, Quattro Select system, which is the waste bin, which is divided into four parts, mm-hmm. which means that it's easier to sort, and then we collect it and put it in different kind of recycling.
That's very smart.
Yes, that's very smart. I recommend it.
And I heard about unusual partnerships that you have here in Finland.
Our message is to our customers that we are a very innovative company. We want to get involved to the new business ideas. Mm-hmm. And this clean tech, as we call it here in Finland, biofuel, it's collecting the waste bread, and they make bioethanol out of it. And the first plant ever in the world was here in Finland, and it was in our site in Lappeenranta, which is in the eastern part of Finland. And the chain robotics, it helps us to sort more carefully, so that it's a really, really minor part of waste that ends up to the landfill or incineration.
Créé à l'issue de travaux de recherche et développement intensif par une société finlandaise high-tech, Zen Robotics est un robot qui optimise le tri des déchets de construction. Ce robot unique au monde a été mis en service sur un des sites de Sita Finlande et est conçu pour trier les déchets industriels et de construction pour lesquels le tri manuel est particulièrement dangereux. Zen Robotics utilise un système de vision et d'intelligence artificielle qui lui permet de déterminer le type de déchets qui arrivent sur le tapis roulant et de sélectionner celui qui a la plus grande valeur en termes de recyclage et de valorisation. Le bois, le métal, le plastique, une fois attrapé, à chaque matériau son conteneur.
Et bien voilà, c'est la fin de cette édition. Je vous souhaite de très belles fêtes de fin d'année et on se quitte sur des images de la campagne finlandaise. À l'année prochaine, ciao !